Theia Henderson. I am a PhD student advised by David Karger, working in human-computer interaction. So the current project I'm working on is titled Graffiti, and it is a project that it's aiming to give users a lot more control over their social applications, whether that is Facebook or Google Docs, and to basically break this phenomenon of lock-in, where, for example, a lot of people use Facebook not because it's what they might prefer to use if they had other options, they use it because it's what their friends use. And so this is a system that shows that it's possible to have social applications that overlap but don't necessarily need to be equal. So there are a couple key elements that lock users into a particular application. Sometimes that might just be code and legal constraints, like for example, Facebook doesn't like people scraping their website and making it look different. But even services that offer specific APIs that you know can let you create your own client, you're really only able to control the presentation of those systems, but not the underlying communication mechanisms. And those might involve the schema of the data, so what sort of actions you're allowed to perform in this social space, moderation of the data, what sort of actions that certain people are allowed to perform on other people's data, and the discovery of data. Basically, this is a subtle property about where data is found, and this can create something called context collapse. If data discovery is not in line with the user's needs. Graffiti is it's a communication architecture, and essentially it's like a very generic backend. You can think of it almost like a file system that you might have on your local computer, but this is a file system that is shared between lots of people at the same time. And it is a file system that has some very special properties with regards to access and moderation, and also the way that data is organized. There's also a front-end API that we've built to Graffiti that lets you write applications using the Vue.js web framework. And these applications can just be hosted on any static website, and anyone can take for example, the applications that are right now on graffiti.csale.mit.edu, you could fork those, you could like literally just copy the code over to your own website, and it will naturally interoperate with all of the other existing applications.